Hi guys, Dr. John back with reaction to Tool. This is Invincible. Some of my subscribers have asked me to listen to it. As most of you know, I'm not an expert on Tool. I don't really know them very well. I've listened and reacted to a few of their songs. This is one of the latest off the last album, so it will be interesting to listen to it and see what I think. So let's bring it up.
Longing tooth and soul, longing for another wind. Lurching to the fray, weapon out and belly in. Warrior, struggling to remain. Consequential. Below, loud, bold and proud.
本身最主要是运用剑桥官方。
Okay, I think I might have inadvertently cut it off a little bit short there, or maybe it was an ad cutting in from YouTube because it was long. But I guess it was coming to the end if it wasn't the end. First impressions. I think Tool, they are masters of the riff and changing up the rhythm of the riff, so they don't base the music on great melodies. No, it's hypnotic riffs, and they can be a bit samey after a while. So what do? They keep changing up the rhythm all the time, and sometimes the instrumentation. The guitar came in interestingly towards the end with a solo. I would say it's similar to some of the previous songs by Tool. Not saying it's the same to listen to, but you can hear a few seconds of it and you know immediately it's by Tool. They have a very distinctive style. It's really all based on that hypnotic riff. So the drums sounded like they were programmed like a drum machine, and even the bass could have been programmed as well. So it's all really based on that riff, and then the lyrics are very interesting about trying to being a warrior, trying to stay relevant, trying to remain consequential. Clearly, there's a metaphor going on here, and probably the main singer, I know he's Maynard, is talking about how Tool has been around for a long time and they've been successful, but now they're getting older and they have to compete with the eager, hungry, young musicians, bands and groups, singers coming through. And the title would give the idea that he thinks that Tool can cope with that and that they still have something to say that will be relevant, and in fact they are invincible. So that's what I get from the lyrics. It does certainly remind me of some of the earlier songs I listened to by Tool. I think it can sometimes get a bit samey, because if you really boil it down and get beyond the metaphors and the philosophy and so on and so forth, you're really left with a riff most of the time, and an interesting voice, but that riff has to be great really to keep it going continuously, and after the song finishes also to think of another riff for the next song. It's experimental music for me. It's interesting because it's experimental. They're trying new things, and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't work so well. But it is interesting, and the riffs they come up with are very interesting. In my opinion, they usually sound pretty ominous, a bit like a Gregorian chant, perhaps. Seem to always be in a kind of minor mode or a minor key. You won't get any greater orgies of joy in Tool. It's all kind of ominous and in a minor mode, but they keep the interest by changing up the rhythm of the riff and the instrumentation, bringing in different instruments, and usually it works very well, as it does here. And I would certainly say that it's great experimental music, and they're trying something new, and they are to be congratulated for that. It's not just the same old thing all the time, just following the herd. They're doing their own thing, and that's admirable, and to be congratulated for that. So, yeah, I enjoyed it, and it has that kind of old-time medieval style to it, which immediately pulls you in. And it's very dramatic music. It's a sort of music that's plays in your mind, and that the rhythms play in your mind and take you along with them. So I enjoyed this song, and we'll be interested to hear more in the future. So hope you enjoyed my reaction. If you did, hit the like button and consider subscribing. Thanks a lot.